Change your heart, change your life, change the planet.
Hey everybody, it's Tim Van Orden coming to you from the Appalachian Trail in Woodford, Vermont. You can see the white blaze on the tree behind me there. And I'm out here processing a race I just did this weekend, or should I say I'm debriefing myself. I'm going over my pre-race thoughts, my plans and strategies, what actually took place in the race, and what I do with that information and how I incorporate that into next steps. The race that I entered was not so much about getting a particular result, it was a test. And I call this type of race an EPO max test. And this has nothing to do with the EPO in your blood. It's actually EP4O max. And what that means to me, E stands for ego, and the P4 is first planning, then projecting, then predicting, and then personalizing, and the O is outcome. So basically what this type of race is, or what this test actually means, is that we can't escape our ego, especially if you're a competitive athlete. So what I wanna do, I wanna have my ego set a plan. It thinks that I'm in a certain level of shape. So, okay, what is my plan for this race? What would I like? Then we project onto my body, onto my training, onto the competition, onto the course, and we run a simulation. We go through the motions and we say, well, I think I can do this. I think I can run at this speed for this amount of time. And then after we've done that projection, we get a prediction. That is the result. It would be nice if the process stopped there, but it doesn't, because what our egos want to do, because they're egos, they want to personalize. So they want to take that predicted outcome and attach their identity to it. We start believing that we are the person in that simulation that we ran, and our ability is actually tied to that predicted result. So we personalize, and we're going to be very disappointed if our body or circumstances somehow betray us. So back to the EPO max test. Why do I have the word max in there? Because I want to see what's possible if I let my ego set the plans, if I let my ego run the simulation or projection, and if I let my ego come up with a predicted result and then personalize. Because if I do that, it's going to get me to move faster. And you can see this on display at the start of any race. You're going to see several, if not many, people sprinting off the start line and then fading within the first half mile because they identified as a faster person than they actually are. Now, if they were doing this as a test, this would be great information. What can I do when my ego is in charge? Because it's probably going to get me to push harder, and I might actually end up surprising myself. But if I use my better judgment, I'm going to go out there and say, well, I haven't been running, so let's try 5:40 pace. Let's be smart. Let's be conservative at the start. Let's work our way into it. That's a good idea if the race is important. But if you really want to find out where your limits are and where you break and what kind of work you need to do at those weak points, let your ego take the steering wheel, or should I say the gas pedal, because you're going to find out what you're made of. You're going to find out very quickly where you break. And that's where the lessons are. The lessons don't come from playing it safe. So if you want to play it safe to get a good result, that's fantastic. But if you want to see what to do next with your training, or to see what you really need to work on, put yourself through an EPO max test. So what I do, I allow my ego to run wild. So I went to this race this weekend. It was a 5K, and the course on the map was flat, and it was the USATF Adirondack 5K Championship. So I knew it would get a very competitive crowd. But I haven't been running for weeks now. I've been doing my Bigfoot Light and my full Bigfoot strides, video coming. So my pace for the last few weeks has been between a 14-minute mile and a 25-minute mile. Super slow, strange walking. Nothing fast at all as I let my Achilles heel spur on my right foot heel. But I know my ego was really, really excited for some super fast times this fall. I wanted to really knock it out of the park in a 5K and go sub 16 minutes. But there are other parts of me that are a little calmer that know that that's no longer a possibility due to my training. But I still need to find out where I am, and thus the EPO max test. So prior to showing up to the race, I let my ego plan a super fast first mile thinking that it can still break 16 minutes, even though the rest of me is quite doubtful that I can do that, let's let my ego take the lead at least for the first mile. And it's saying 5 minutes to 5:10, we can do that. Then what are you gonna do for the second mile, ego? I don't know, I think we can hold on to 5:15 pace. Okay, sounds great. How about mile three, ego? Well, we have been walking a lot, so I don't know, we'll probably slow down to a 5:30. We're probably gonna be pretty tired. Okay, that's a fast time. If you can do that, fantastic. So my ego runs the simulation by looking at the course map. It does its projection of my body and what it believes to be my current state of fitness into that course with the competition that I know is gonna be there, the speed that I know they're going to be running based on what they've just done recently. And then I get a prediction. And my ego says, well, if it's a good day, that third mile will be faster and we'll run, say, a 15:50. If it's not such a good day, the third mile is probably going to be a 5:30 and we're going to run 16:15, but still a really good time for my age. And how cool would it be if I could run that fast only by walking as my training? So that's my prediction. And then the personalization starts. And this is something that I'm very, very aware of as I've studied psychology and I coach people. We get attached to our predictions and we start imagining and fantasizing about how cool it's going to be if we can actually do that without knowing what we're actually capable of yet. We ratchet our identity up one or two or 10 notches to the level that we think we should be at or in the fantasy that we're at. And we say, yeah, I like that guy. I'm impressed by that guy. Yeah, that's me. I can do that. Mm-hmm. That's the goal. And when you show up at the start, you ask everybody, what are you planning on doing today? What are you hoping for? And they're going to tell you. And almost never do they actually run what they planned. It's very, very rare that somebody actually gets the time that they want. So almost everybody is disappointed. Not always. Some people set PRs. But I've heard people set PRs and then still be disappointed. It's like, that's as fast as you've ever run. Yeah, but I was hoping for more. You personalized a super fast result. You attached your identity to it. And even though you broke your personal record, it still doesn't feel as good as the fantasy that you had. Now you're disappointed. So what happened for me in the race that I just ran, even though on the map it looked perfectly flat and super fast, but the map lied. This was a cross-country course. Even though it's advertised as a 5K road championship of sorts, there was gravel, it was dirt, there was mud, there was grass, there were steep hills, there were sharp corners. It was not that fast at all. In fact, all the guys in the front were saying that they ran about 30 seconds slower than they have run recently on the road. So the first mile we went through in a 5:12, which is a quick time for a road race, but a super fast time for someone my age on a cross-country course. So after running that 5:12, I found my limit. My body was not happy and I started to quickly slow down. And I think my next mile was a 5:40 and my final mile was a 5:50 with maybe 5:20 speed sprinting to the finish. So I found out where my limits are. I found out what is realistic for me as I hit into cross country season. I'm not gonna be able to run as fast as I had thought or hoped. So now I've got to dial back my expectations when I go to the New England Championships this coming weekend. So thanks to running this EPO Max test, I'm not going to go out and get in over my head and have a terrible race when it actually matters. So I hope there's some value in there for you, and let me know in the comments below what you think and if you've tried something like this. It's super, super helpful for me, and I do it many times throughout the year to find out where I'm actually at by going faster than I know that I should. Ego, baby, all the way. All right, I'll see you soon. Bye.